Dear friends, welcome back. Today we take a look and review the new Arduino Due board. We bought this board from banggood.com a few days ago and it came here fast, and now we have the chance to review it. First of all, the Arduino Due uses a new ARM M3 Cortex microprocessor. This is the processor here. It is a 32-bit processor and it runs at 84 MHz. This is a huge improvement in computational power, comparing it with an Arduino Mega, which is 8-bit and of course 16 MHz. Also, now we have two USB inputs. One is for communication and programming, this one here, and the other can be used as a host. So you can plug in a mouse or a keyboard and use it with an Arduino. Also, in this new board there is a huge improvement in ADC performance. Now we have 12-bit inputs, analog inputs and outputs, and you can see, that is the new here, that there are two digital to analog converter connected pins. So this board has two digital to analog converters embedded, and you can use it and use them with those two pins. Also, there is a huge boost in the program file memory. This microprocessor has built-in 512 kilobytes of flash memory, so the program file can be up to 512 kilobytes. Very, very large. It's exactly double the size of the flash memory of the Arduino Mega 2560. Also, the RAM of the device is up. We now have 96 kilobytes of SRAM. It also has a controller so that the processor can use the RAM very, very fast. But this device, because it uses an ARM microprocessor, it uses the 3.3 volt logic. So each pin of the device is tolerant to 3.3 volts only and not to 5 volts. So if you enter 5 volts in any pins, you will blow up the pin. Because of this, many shields are not compatible with this Arduino board, because it is not, as we said, 5 volt tolerant. Also, it does not have an EEPROM memory, so we cannot have some variable saved for later use. Each time we upgrade the firmware, any data that we have saved in the flash memory are erased. Now let's check the power consumption. I'm going to plug it in and see how much current it draws. Now that Arduino is up and running, as you can see, the power consumption is almost half a watt. It draws 100 milliamps of current. So the power consumption on this board is the biggest from all Arduino boards, but of course this board is the fastest and more capable of all. So this power consumption is not a big deal if you are not running from batteries. Now let's see how to program the Arduino Due and blink the onboard LED. First of all, in order to use the new Arduino Due board, you don't have to use the standard Arduino IDE software, but you have to download the latest version, the 1.5 and up version of the Arduino IDE. So let's install it and see how to use it. Now the Arduino IDE is open and we can load the standard blink program and load it to our Arduino Due. We have to go to Tools, board, select the Arduino board, the Arduino Due at programming port, select the port manually, important, don't miss it, and then click the upload button. As you can see, the sketch is now compiling and it's now flashing it into the memory. That's it. It's done. So that's the Arduino Due board. It is a very capable board and it has a huge improvement in computational power. If your project needs a fast processor, you have to use this one. Else you can choose any other Arduino board. We are going to use it for some projects in the future, so please subscribe to our channel if you want to watch more, and press like if you liked our review. Thank you very much.